Vegas police furious at what hotel was just caught lying about as truth bomb just blows investigation wide open. MGM Resorts International, the owner of the Mandalay Bay Casino and Resorts, issued a statement Tuesday evening sternly questioning the most recent timeline that was provided by police for the Las Vegas massacre, which happened 2 weeks ago this coming Sunday. They have gone as far as to say it may not be accurate. MGM's statement came just one day after Las Vegas Metropolitan Police officials revealed that the Mandalay Bay security guard who is credited with heroically stalling Las Vegas shooter Stephen Paddock had actually been shot before his rampage even started. According to authorities, Paddock shot the guard at 9:59 p.m., which is 6 minutes before he opened fire on the crowd at the Country Music Route 91 Harvest Festival, where he killed 58 people and injured nearly 500 more. Officers with the LVPD said they arrived at the 32nd floor suite at 10:17 p.m., where they, in fact, found the wounded guard about a minute later. Original timeline. This is the original timeline of events given out by police last Wednesday. 10:05 p.m., Paddock fires his first shots on the crowd, as seen on CCTV. 10:12 p.m., first two officers arrive on the 31st floor and announce gunfire is coming from directly above them. 10:14 p.m., guard Jesus Campos approaches Paddock's room and is shot, but only injured. 10:15 p.m., the last shots are fired from the suspect, per body cam, due to Campos' intervention. 10:17 p.m., the first two officers arrive on the 32nd floor from the 31st. 10:18 p.m., Campos tells the cops he was shot and gives them the exact location of the suspect's room. 10:26 to 10:30 p.m., with Paddock quiet, eight additional cops arrive and they decide to evacuate the rooms on the floor. 10:55 p.m., eight officers arrive in the stairwell next to the suspect's room and find the door tampered with and a camera on a room service card outside. They decide to hold off. 11:20 p.m., Paddock's room is breached and police enter the room to find him dead. But here is where the discrepancies start. Clark County Sheriff Joe Lombardo had previously said that Paddock stopped shooting at concertgoers at 10:15 p.m. after being spooked by the guard. But this couldn't have happened if the guard was shot before the killing actually started. So it's ultimately unclear why he stopped firing. Another question that remains is what the guard did after being shot by Paddock. Authorities have not indicated whether the guard notified casino security or called for backup after being shot, and it's also not clear if any other staff members or guests knew about the initial incident or saw or heard something. New timeline. This is the new timeline given out on Monday. 9:59 p.m., Campos approaches Paddock's room looking for an alarm going off at a door nearby, likely from the stairwell. He is shot at and injured. He immediately notifies hotel security. Stephen Shuck appears to back up this account. 10:05 p.m., first shots fired by suspect. 10:12 p.m., first two officers arrive on the 31st floor. 10:15 p.m., the last shots are fired from the suspect for reasons unknown. 10:17 p.m., the first two officers arrive on the 32nd floor from the 31st. 10:18 p.m., Campos, who has been stricken for almost 20 minutes, tells police about Paddock's room. 10:26 to 10:30 p.m., with Paddock quiet, eight more cops arrive and they decide to evacuate the rooms on the floor. 10:55 p.m., eight officers arrive in the stairwell next to the suspect's room and find the door tampered with and a camera on a room service card outside. They decide to hold off. 11:20 p.m., Paddock's room is breached and police enter the room to find him dead. Bloomberg reports. MGM Resorts says police were in hotel when Vegas shooting began. MGM Resorts International said Las Vegas Metropolitan Police were on the premises of its Mandalay Bay Hotel when the deranged guest began firing on concertgoers in an October 1 attack that killed 58 people. The casino operator said the 9:59 p.m. time previously given out as the moment the shooting began isn't accurate. That report was collected manually after the fact and new information is now available, MGM Resorts said Thursday in a statement. Shots were being fired at the concert site within 40 seconds after MGM security guard Jesus Campos was wounded, the company said. Metro officers were together with armed Mandalay Bay security officers in the building when Campos first reported that shots were fired over the radio, MGM Resorts said. These Metro officers and armed Mandalay Bay security officers immediately responded to the 32nd floor. MGM Resorts, the largest owner of casinos on the Las Vegas Strip, said it was responding to misinformation about the shooting. Las Vegas police on